You know how your mom told you to eat your broccoli? She was right. You better eat it or you gon' die. Hey everyone, Laci Green here for D News. I'm not ashamed to admit it, broccoli is one of my all-time favorite vegetables, and now there's an excuse to eat like 25 pounds of them per day. Approximately. You may have seen Trace's video he did a while back about how China is one of the most polluted countries in the world. The World Health Organization recommends that cities not exceed a fine particle concentration of 25 micrograms. These are the particles that can penetrate deeply into your lungs and enter the bloodstream. Beijing's concentration is over 500 micrograms. The Shanghai Academy of Social Sciences report that Beijing's pollution is so bad it's almost uninhabitable by humans. It's rough times, you guys. But now, broccoli is coming to the rescue. Research from Johns Hopkins on 300 men and women in rural China found that by drinking a beverage with broccoli sprouts every day, they can excrete some of the pollutants through their urine. Compared to the control group, the group that was drinking the broccoli sprout drink excreted 60% more benzene out of their pee and 23% more acrolein. Benzene is a known carcinogen. It's been linked repeatedly with leukemia and other blood-related cancers. Acrolein, on the other hand, is a chemical that causes irritation of the respiratory tract. It may also cause cancer. Scientists don't really know for sure. The drink might even help secrete other pollutants as well. The scientists just studied these two because they're the most stable molecules. Good for tracking. They found that throughout all 3 months of the study, the benzene and acrolein secretion stayed the same too, so it wasn't just a one-time thing. So how is it that broccoli sprouts are able to work this wizardry? Broccoli contains glucoraphanin, which when you eat it creates another compound called sulforaphane. Sulforaphane signals enzymes in your body to get to work. It breaks down the pollutants to be washed out through your urine. But unfortunately, science thinks that sulforaphane only breaks down chemicals you've just been exposed to, so it may not be very helpful for pollutants, pesticides, and other nasty junk that are already lingering in your fat cells. Scientists have also observed indirect antioxidant effects with sulforaphane. The enzymes it catalyzes can block chemicals in the body from becoming carcinogenic. So it's kind of magical, isn't it? Eat this, pee this out. Sometimes I'm just in awe of the human body and all those complicated chemical processes that are going inside you all at the same time. And all you gotta do to amp it up is eat your broccoli. Thanks for joining me for D News, everyone. If you're looking for another interesting tidbit, check out Trace's new Test Tube Daily video, where he discusses what the autism spectrum actually consists of.
They're all brain development disorders, and each has a different mix of symptoms, a different level of severity, and a different time in which they start affecting people.
And in the meantime, what's your favorite vegetable? Tell me about it down below, and I'll see you next time.